Arrack is used in many parts of the world. However, Sri Lankan arrack is one of the most underused and lesser known kinds of arrack. While arrack would mean it's a very local drink to any country, Sri Lankan arrack has a very prominent place in both the Sri Lankan history and the booze culture of the world. Keeping aside the wonderful taste, there is a rich background of how this is made and why it is considered as one of the best beverages of the world. But the question still remains, did the British bring arrack to Sri Lanka? The answer is a simple big no. Historical records have shown that arrack can be traced back to 5th century AD. It can be believed that it has been around much longer than that. Although there are no written records, stories and paintings illustrate that kings indulged in arrack and it was a very popular drink among the warriors back in the day. While that rules out the question if the British had brought arrack to Sri Lanka, it is also interesting to know that they definitely contributed to where it is at today. Today, as we speak, Sri Lankan arrack is one of the most sought-after sold beverages in upstate restaurants of London as well. Not to be ignored, it is also served in most of the restaurants in the United States as well. In 1658, under the Dutch rule, the arrack industry resulted in a greater development. It served as a great commodity to bring in revenues through exports, and it is one of the most important products of the trade involved between countries. When the British took over in 1802, exports grew by almost 800% by 1813. It could also be important to understand how is it made. Sri Lankan arrack is made from the coconut flower sap. It's called as toddy as well. It's collected over 2 weeks. A bunch of these flower saps are tied together and the edges are chipped off every day. And over the course of the next 14 to 15 days, droplets from these saps are collected into a clay vessel or a pot. It's then filtered and fermented for 15 days. The wild yeast and the natural bacteria get to work. In the process, it gets fermented. This fermented liquid is moved into wooden containers, sent to distillation, and then blended by experts for the right blend. During the whole process, it's interesting to know that the alcohol percent goes up to as much as 60%. In the process of blending, distilling, filtering, and adding water in the course of time, the percentage comes down to 40%. Now that we know that the British did not bring arrack to Sri Lanka, and the whole question came into my mind because in one of my trips to Sri Lanka, one of the managers had told me that the British were the ones who brought the arrack to Sri Lanka and they brewed it. However, that's not true because arrack has been a part of Sri Lankan culture since the 5th century. A couple of interesting facts about the Sri Lankan arrack. It's the most sold Sri Lankan beverage in the country. Not just that, it's one of the all-natural alcoholic beverages in the world. And there are a lot of premium brands that are blended and exported to other countries like United States and some parts of United Kingdom as well. However, it needs to be noted that Sri Lankan arrack has a rich culture to it and a rich background to it, and it's one of the most consumed beverages in Sri Lanka without a doubt. If you have any plans of visiting Sri Lanka, hopefully in the future, please do give this a try and do not hesitate because it's the best of the best of the best. Cheers guys, until then, my name is Casey. See you in the next video with another interesting story. Bye bye.